Hello, hello, Home Assistant 2023.8 is here and I'll share what is new and hot in this latest release. So, let's start. If you set up your Home Assistant for the first time with Home Assistant 2023.8 version or higher, you can now search for your exact location instead of manually dragging the map with your mouse to find your address. This feature is powered by the OpenStreetMap service. Next, there is a new AI Home Assistant service powered by OpenAI that can generate images. Actually, I use this service to generate this whole video. Just kidding. To use this new service, you need an OpenAI subscription. After that, you can describe the image you want to be generated in the prompt section of the service. When this service is invoked, you receive a URL as a response. If you copy and paste that URL in a browser, you see the generated image. Although I can't think of any immediately useful applications, this service can be used for some weird or fun automations or script. If you have any ideas, please share them in the comments. Next new feature in Home Assistant 2023.8 is translatable services. That means services in Home Assistant can be now translated into languages other than English. Previously, if you set your Home Assistant to a different language, everything would be displayed in that language except for the service names in automations and developer tools, for example. However, starting from this release, services will be available in your selected language, provided it has already been translated. If not, you can contribute by doing the translation yourself. The Home Assistant team has promised to prepare a step-by-step tutorial on how to do these translations, making it accessible for everyone to contribute. All you need is a browser and an internet connection. I'll leave the link to this step-by-step tutorial in the video description for those interested in joining the translation team. The next new thing is the most exciting one for me, and it is called Event Entity. When you press a button on a device added to Home Assistant, an event will be emitted. This event can then be captured in an automation or script, allowing you to create useful home automations. However, the problem so far was catching the event. You had to go to the developer tools to listen and subscribe to an event to figure out its exact name and data. Then, you had to go to the event trigger, for example, to configure everything based on the data gathered from the developer tools, hoping you didn't miss anything for your creation to work. All of this could be a tricky and time-consuming activity, but not anymore. The event entity is here to save the day, or at least to save some time. The event entity captures events from the physical world and makes them available in Home Assistant as entities. For example, when a button like a doorbell is pressed, it will trigger an event entity. You can see that event in the logbook as the event entity keeps a history. You can even inquire about the last time a certain event was triggered, and that opens a lot more possibilities, don't you think? So, instead of dealing with complicated event triggers, you can now simply start using state triggers with the event entity selected in your automations. And if that is not enough, starting from Home Assistant 2023.8, this new event entity is now supported by Matter, HomeKit, MQTT and Philips Hue integrations. If some of the terms and acronyms that I'm using sound strange to you, get ready to level up your smart home knowledge with my free smart home glossary. Inside this awesome PDF file, you'll find a treasure of smart home terms, each explained in simple, easy to understand language. No more scratching your head over confusing jargon. I got you covered with straightforward explanations that will make you a smart home pro in no time. Don't miss out this valuable resource. Reserve your copy now. Grab it at https://automatelike.pro/glossary. Next, there is a condition selector. This Home Assistant 2023.8 option that is introduced now can be utilized within blueprints in the condition selector. This new selector grants access to the condition section of the automation editor, enabling blueprint creators to incorporate custom user-provided conditions in their designs. Starting from Home Assistant 2023.8 and onwards, you can ask Home Assistant to add items to your shopping list. Once an item is added, there is currently no option to remove or rename it using Assist. For now, you can only check off items using your phone or other means, going to your shopping list integration. It is not yet possible to add multiple items with one sentence. For example, if you say add bread and butter to your shopping list, you get one line saying bread and butter. Nevertheless, this is a great start and the foundations look solid. As you might know, Home Assistant releases updates every month, so I believe this feature will be further enhanced sooner rather than later. Wildcard in Home Assistant 2023.8 and higher can now be used in sentence triggers. That means you can use something like play album by artist in the sentence trigger of an automation. And as an action, you can start playing that specific album by that artist. You can also use the TTS service to confirm the action through your media player. Python 3.10 support has been removed. This only concerns people running Home Assistant Core, which is Home Assistant running in a Python environment. All other installation types, Home Assistant OS, Supervised and Container, don't have to do anything as they are already on Python 3.11, which is faster and well supported at the time of shooting this video. By the way, do you want to level up your Home Assistant installation type knowledge and to learn all pros and cons plus some tips and tricks? If so, join my free and fun Home Assistant webinar. Grab your seat now at automatelike.pro/webinar before they disappear. Thanks for watching. I'm Kiryu and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!